So this morning I'm coming on to a 24-hour shift for family practice OB. So I'm just gonna go get handover and then we'll go around on our patients and see if there's anybody in active labor.
First two are L&D.
Mm-hmm.
The first one gave birth yesterday at 3, well, today actually at 3 a.m.
Mm-hmm. I may not sleep for the next 24 hours. Sometimes I get a little bit of a nap in the afternoon if it's quiet. So Sunnybrook has been really, really nice. And they've let me take on extra calls, so I do a shift a month to just do OB. So yeah, I just fly in to help out with the call, and the women's residents are really happy about that because not a lot of people are actually interested in obstetrics. So it's pretty awesome. The first part of our day on call is we round on the patients that are on the floor. So she's the one that was admitted with preterm labor.
Right, so she's 28 weeks old.
Yeah. Couple patients that aren't actually admitted under us, they're admitted under the high-risk obstetrical group, but we still want to keep that continuity of care, and we want people to feel like we're actually taking care of them and actively involved with them, regardless of if they're under our service or not. So we went and we offered just some supportive care, see how they're doing.
As long as your baby's there, you can be there too.
Okay. Having the senior medical students with you allows you to give them sort of some teaching, and then they can help you out too. So if it's a busy day on call, they can go and they can do some of the consults.
Yeah, that's why I go for bi-weekly manicures.
Oh, nice. So it's pretty much the most important thing that you're looking for in the second baby check. A lot of the things won't change. So if there was a previously closed palate, that's not gonna change, it's not gonna open. So between 5 and 7, we see clinic patients, but otherwise it's just, can finish up any stuff that I have in my clinic downstairs. I can do some work on my academic project or just have a nap. If it's not busy in the afternoon, I tend to get a nap because overnight is when you tend to see a lot of the volume. But it may be a quiet day. Never say the keyword on the ward, so I've just screwed us over now, so we're gonna be crazy busy.
The high-risk team is gonna look after that, so they're treating.
On the labor and delivery floor, there's never really a typical day, so we can go from having absolutely no patients to being completely swamped and having 5 people in labor, 6 people in labor at the same time. But typically around 5 o'clock we'll have a clinic, an obstetrical patient clinic, and then we'll see what happens from there. Excellent.
Okay, you're done.
So we just finished I'm finishing up my 24-hour shift for family practice OB. It was quite unusual of a 24-hour shift because I actually had no deliveries, no patients in labor. Only had one call to triage, and that was actually early in the afternoon.
And they were saying to discharge their mom today.
To prepare for a 24-hour shift, the best thing you can do is get a good night's sleep the day before. Sometimes it's difficult to do that, but that'll be the thing that keeps you going. You find your little things that keep you awake and keep you energized. Adrenaline is the big thing that does it, but then there are things like people like green tea, cupcakes, coffee. I like to bring my own big fluffy blanket because I find it gets really cold at night. And it's a little piece of home too, because when you sleep away from home, it can be a bit uncomfortable. I love delivering, it's so much fun. It can be really, really quiet, or it can be crazy, you want to pull your hair out, and that's part of the appeal for me, and usually a happy time for people, so you're helping them through that, which is great.